as a believer, we always should be questioning ourselves and making sure that our intention is always trying to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm your brother Uthman al-Talib with your daily Dhul Hijjah reminders about Ibrahim alayhi salam. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen. Alhamdulillah, yet now we are in the next step of the journey with Ibrahim alayhi salam, where he's been saved from the fire that his people had thrown him into, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed him from it. And so now we move into the next step, and the lesson for today is really the search for yaqeen, the search for comfort in our hearts, for what we believe in, and the connection that we have to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so Ibrahim alayhi salam, throughout his life, the consistent theme that we can see in the Quran is that he was always searching for certainty, for a reinstated conviction in his belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why he is known to be the father of monotheism, because he is continuously searching and making sure that he is comfortable with what he is, what conclusion he has reached in believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so one beautiful statement and experience between Ibrahim alayhi salam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we find in Surah Al-Baqarah that solidifies this for us is an ayah where Ibrahim alayhi salam asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show him how Allah brings the dead back to life. And so he asks Allah, Rabbi arini kayfa tuhyi al-mawta. Oh Allah, show me how you bring the dead back to life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks him a very critical question. He says, awalam tu'min? He says, are you asking me because you don't believe? And Ibrahim alayhi salam responds to him very beautifully. He says, bala walakin liyatma'inna qalbi. He said, absolutely, you know, undoubtedly, I believe. But rather, I want my heart to find itmi'nan. I want my heart to find conviction, to find comfort, to find serenity in this decision and this reality that I have come to in believing in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a believer, we always should be questioning ourselves and making sure that our intention is always trying to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trying to find a newfound conviction in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to never be comfortable with where we're at without actually evaluating ourselves. And through that evaluation and that questioning, we reach a sense of certainty and comfort and conviction. But the intention always has to be that we're doing it so that we can come closer to Allah. When we question and doubt, but we don't have an intention to come closer to Allah, then we go down the path of shaitan. We go down the path that will take us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so Ibrahim alayhi salam is a true example of how we come closer to Allah. And so the story that I want to share with you today about Ibrahim alayhi salam is one that we can find in Surah Al-An'am, where Ibrahim alayhi salam goes out into nature, and the nighttime befalls him, and he sees a star. And so he asks himself, he said, this star is huge. This is a large, this is a big star. It's a big piece of creation. Maybe this is worthy of being a god, right? It's worthy of being worshipped. And so once the sun came out and he could no longer see the star, he said, nope, this star can't be God. You know, this star cannot be an ilah. It can't be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah is always there. And so by the star leaving or not being seen during the daylight, he said, this can't be a Rabb. This can't be my Lord. And so then he saw the moon rise. And so the moon was larger than the star. And so he said, okay, this has to be and a god. This has to be a god. And once the sun came up and he could no longer see the moon, it went away, and he said, there's no way I will be able to reach Allah and find true certainty unless he guides me. And so then he saw the sun come up, and the sun was the largest of these creations. And he said, this has to be Allah. This has to be a god, because it's the biggest of the creation. And then once the sun set, he finally came to the conclusion, or even just the rational explanation, because there's many interpretations of who he's talking to. Is it for himself? Is it for others? But there's a rational conclusion that a person can come to say, all of these creation cannot be God, cannot be ones that are worthy of worship, because they all disappear. They all become unseen, and they are all controlled by one who is greater than them, one who is more powerful than them. And so this is a true example of a person that has the right intention of always trying to come closer to Allah, one who is always evaluating themselves, checking themselves, making sure that their heart is in the right place, and that we're always trying to find a way to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and bring others with us. And so a lot of times we can't just sit there and quote the Quran, we can't sit there and quote hadith to explain a feeling and a conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes you have to take people on a path, on a journey with you, and ask critical questions, existential questions that allow them to think, and it makes it clear to them who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, and the use of nature, the use of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation is one of the foremost tactics that can be used to, one, reinstill our belief and conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also bring others with us. And so the lesson for today is really to reconnect with creation. Go outside, look at the moon, look at the sun, look at the stars, reconnect with Allah. Know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of all of these magnificent images and views that we can see on a daily basis. And they are just a recurring evidence for us to the existence of Allah, the power of Allah, the might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to follow in the path of Ibrahim alayhi salam, to always reevaluate ourselves, always check ourselves to know why we are finding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why we are coming to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is because Allah is the only one who is worthy of worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who is worthy of our submission. And we ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts us in these blessed days and these blessed nights, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us the highest levels of yaqeen, of certainty, of conviction, and the highest levels of comfort and serenity in our hearts. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.